You know, that's a problem. There is no legal basis for being there. Walang holdover sa barangay. They are just there, I don't know, de facto, whatever. But the reason why I advise Congress, kinausap ko ito si Senator Soto, sinabi ko, because he knows the problem very well, but fingertips niya itong drug, eh, kalaban niya, is I sabi ko sa kanila, do not commit the mistake of calling for an elections now, because narco politics has entered into the mainstream of Philippine politics. Ang manalo nito, yung mga barangay captain nga sa listahan natin, either patayin mo na natin itong mga yawa na ito, kasi kung pagka hindi, they will be elected again and you have the looming elections next 20. The local elections, it's just around the corner. Kung nandyan ito, and they can influence the electorate, magkakaroon ng utang na loob itong mga officials, delikado, because then you'll have completed the conversion of this country into a narco-politics state, the jure. Kaya sabi ko, wag muna, but they are there. I do not know what Senator Soto. Anong plano nila? Sabi ko, it's quite a bit messy. Kasi pagka tinanggal mo rin ang mga gagong to, magsigawa na, no? We are looking for a way to appoint na lang the barangay captains, but the mechanism of how to go about it, select them. Ako, I can, but you know, it's always the president who has the power to appoint. But I'm going to compromise with the church and everybody. They can nominate 3 citizens from pagka magsabi ang PDEA, pati ang police, and the military, that they have no connections with the rebels. That's one. Second is that they are not into drugs. And third is that they are not really the leaders of politicians. If you can have that list, I would be happy to just, coming from the Roman Catholic, from the Islam group, the Jehovah Witnesses, it's not actually interference, it's the preference of the character that should be there. Election eh. Hindi naman sabihin nakikialam yung simbahan. And the lions or lahat, lista mo lang yung accredited, they can nominate. So we can do away with shady characters. Pero pag ginawa mong election ngayon, ito ang mananalo, yung nasa listahan. 40% of the total barangay captains are into drugs. That's my problem. Kaya kayong mga Pilipino, be sure to elect. Kasi hindi ko kaya kung ako lang. Wala akong panahon na patayin silang lahat. Tulungan ninyo ako. Yung next, ano, be careful. Be careful with drugs. Dilika pera yan eh. Tinanong ko nga, I ask somebody sa plane, how long did it take you to earn your first million? Tanongin ko si, he need not answer. Tanongin ko si Speaker William, sir, kailan ka kumita ng first million mo, second million? Years yan. Lahat dito nagtrabaho. Drugs. May ulol na mayor. He distributed drugs on the east side. Yung udikta na yon was on the west side. And how many Filipinos are deranged now because of their activities? They cook drugs, 2 months, they are millionaire. Kaya maraming pumapasok dyan. It's the greed, money. Bantay kayo dyan. it's easy to produce and you destroy a generation of Filipinos. Kaya nga ako sa OFW, let me lecture, 2 minutes. Kaya dumudugo yung puso ko. Nakita ko sila lahat shouting, Duterte, gano'n na, with all the adulation and clapping. But what was in my mind while I was looking at them? Yung pagod nila, nandoon nga sa ibang bayan, yung sa ibang countries, 2-3 oras lang ang tulog because they are transferred from one household to another to clean. So itong anak, walang helper doon siya. Then he has to clean the room of another relative. That's why they say it's uniform. Hindi ba din yung nakita? They are only allowed 3 to 4 hours of sleep. Have you not noticed that? And they are abused, raped. And they endure it, most of them. Mga anak na lang dyan sa aeroplano. Tangina kayo. Yan ang masakit sa akin. Ang tatay nandito, yung gaday na doon, they work hard, endure abuses, so that they can send money here sa mga anak nila para mag-aral. And after years of toil, madisgrasya, mag-uwi dito, nakita nila anak nila, babae, naging whatever, o hindi, na biktima ng mga drugista. Why? Diyan sa baba ang pinakalaban, ang the miserable life is there. Then you add to their misery. You do not even consider for a moment the blood, sweat, and tears of the Filipino, millions of them outside of the country. Tapos mukainin niyo ako na, kaya kayong mga pare. Ilan? 10,000? Papatay ako ng 50. Sinabi ko naman, if you destroy my city, I will kill you. If you destroy my country, the more that I will kill you. I said, I will kill. Sa awa ng Diyos, wala pa akong pinatay ni isa ngayon. Kung hindi kayo bigay, hindi ko sinabing utusan ko yung police, pati sundalo magpatay. But if they kill those idiots, yung mga ulol sa buhay, in the performance of their duties, in obedience to my order, I will take the consequences. Do not worry. And if I will have to rot in prison, I will do it. Because not everybody is given the chance by God to be president. Not everybody, not Filipino na maging presidente. Putang ina, magpakamatay ako sa Filipino. Let's say kayo. Talagang yayariin ko kayo. Do not do it. Drop siyabo. Drop everything. Kayong mga politiko, I warned you. The mayors and all, barangay captains, huwag kayo talagang magkamali. Yayariin ko kayo. Do not do it to the Filipino. Not lalo na ngayon. Ihirit ako ng ihirit. I do not really care what your mayor. Ako mismo magamit ng barit. Ako ang babaril sa iyo. Hindi kita madala sa ambas, barilin kita sa malayo. Lalo na yung mga political holding power. Do not do it. You are courting death there. Prangka-prangka na lang tayo.